Hello and welcome. Today I wanted to talk about screws. These are very, very handy. And this is a Spax. A really nice one. I love these because they have the torx in them. And I have quite a collection of them. I got 1¼ inch, 1½ inch. And I use these things extensively to screw things together. So for example, take this IKEA extender leg. This is a really nice one. And come on, camera. You get the picture. That's the PLA stuff that I was telling you about last time. And in here I can insert a screw, and this is exactly how these two are connected together. So the question is, how do I insert a screw? And there are a couple ways to do this. One of them is through the models that you've designed, and today I'm going to show you that way. I'm going to show you a very interesting module if you use OpenScad, and also I'll show you the way how to do it through slicer. So maybe a slicer in the next video. So we are going to take a look at the module I created, and I'm gonna put the links into the description in here. The module is going to be, hold on a sec. So I'm gonna show you how to do it in OpenScad. So this is the OpenScad in the module I've done. So you see that it's Spax 20 for torx 20. And this is a parameter, so how long the screw is. So this one is 82.5 millimeters. I'm not sure how much is it in inches. I still have not adapted. So, so this is nice. You could basically pass a parameter into there, and you could say, all right, I want this to be, I don't know, 40. And we're gonna do a save and a render. And you see that it has rendered. So let me explain the parts in here. So this is kind of the length of the screw. And this is the bit that is very important for to make it countersunk, so that when you're working with your model, so that the screw doesn't stick out or doesn't go too deep. So I like them flush, and it's a very nice feeling when the things are flush. And in here, the magenta thing is a space for the actual adapter when you screw this in. Typically, I screw these in into something very long, so it regularly needs that thick adapter. So I made it about 10 mil so that the elongator, that long thing, can stick into my model. And this is the way I use it. So what happens in here, these are the different color things. What you need to do is you just need to copy paste this thing and use it in your OpenScad module. And this is how you instantiate a screw. So you basically say, use that module and give me a screw of 40 mils long. Since it's the number 8 screw, all the other parameters like thickness will stay the same. So let's take a look at how we use this. So right now we're going to make a hole, and that hole is going to be in a cube. And that hole is going to be screw in a cube. And let's see what happens. So this is a cube, and it's a 30-30-30 cube. And this is a screw that's going to be flush in here. So when I render this, it nicely becomes flush and all of that. Kind of an interesting tip in here is that you could also basically paste the same screw to see how much it sticks out. What I usually do with that information sticks out is when I have to screw something into wood, for example, or into a wall. So I don't want this to be sticking out too far or make a hole in my table in here. So what I usually have is I gauge how much it sticks out. I know that this particular tabletop is 27 mils thick. So I don't want this to be sticking out 33 because it will damage the tabletop. So when I was modeling my Surface 3 dock thing, I made sure that I use the proper screws, and I also do not make this thing too long. So I'll put the model in the description. However, if you are not the not making your models yet, but you still need to adjust somebody else's module, let me show you how to do this in a slicer. We're gonna figure it out. So right now I've got the cube. It's slightly bigger than 30-30-30. It is 5 centimeters cube, about almost 2 inches for those of you who are using the weird numbering system. So right now we're going to basically virtually drill it. So what we're going to do is the same trick that I used in the last video. I'm going to add a modifier, and I'm going to load an object in here, and I'm going to load probably one of these. Whoa, that is huge. I probably need to scale it down. I did not expect that. So it's probably a factor of 10. It's so huge. Yep, sounds about right. Let me figure this out. All right, I got to the bottom of it. So this is fascinating. So the way I arrived to this cube is I took a 1 centimeter cube and multiplied by 5. So when I add a modifier, it also multiplies the modifier. Who knew? Now I know. So it's going to be pretty cool. So let's load the long screw. And you won't have to do this part if you didn't scale your model and you're using the original one. But I'm going to change the modifier on this one to make it 5 times smaller. And then I have to move it a little bit. So when I'm moving it, that is very handy for me to figure out what is it going to be. So I want to move this modifier in here and sink it a little bit. And it's great to see the thing sticking out, so that if I have a long object and I really need the strength in the wall, I see that the body of the screw is going to be very long in here. Or I want to make it countersunk so that I could just line it up closer like this and basically do a video. So my child showed up and he wants a dinner. So let me wrap this up real quick. So basically what we'll do is we will take this and use the same tricks like we used to before. Infill and layers are gonna be set all to 0. So 0, 0, 0 and another 0 and 0 and another 0. And then when you slice it, it's going to have a nice hole in it. So really well. So this is the way for you to quickly put a hole for a screw in a random model that you find on Thingiverse. And by the way, the screws are also in Thingiverse. So thank you for tuning in. If you find it instructive and you liked it and you learned something new, just click the like button. Thank you and see you next time.